Can a 3D printed speaker sound as good as a wooden speaker? Well, today we're gonna find that out. But before we do that, let's take a look at the speaker that we're going to be testing. This is the Rule Breaker Center Channel speaker, and this is a speaker that I designed to get rid of the off-axis issues that you have with a typical MTM center channel, especially with these smaller center channel speakers. Now, if you all know a little bit more about this particular speaker and its design, go ahead and check the video. I'll put it right up here. But let's go ahead and take a look at the construction of each one of these. For this particular speaker, I used a laser to cut multiple layers, and you can see the layers being stacked up, and they've been stacked together. This gives it a really nice, strong cabinet. Now, the wood that I used on this is cherry wood, and then the front baffle is actually made out of maple. So it's a very hard wood as well, and this cabinet is very, very strong. 3D printed one, I used the exact same files that I used to laser cut this, but I designed this in software so that it would be the exact same size and even use the exact same thickness material. For that material, we cut this at a half inch, and this would also be a half inch. Now, the actual settings that I used on the 3D printer is a 50% infill with 7 top and bottom layers. So this one I did 3D print with the Creality K1 3D printer. I absolutely love that printer. If you're looking for one, great printer. Did have to do it in 2 parts because it wouldn't fit. So I did have to glue these together, sand it down, and then of course I added a little bit of paint as well. Now that we know the basic construction of these speakers, we gotta find out if there's any differences in how they sound. So let's look at some test results first. All right, the first test, I want to hook up my DATS V3 and I want to test the impedance curve.
As we look at these graphs, we want to make sure there's no major differences between them. So we're looking at the big humps and we're also looking at these small little humps. And as we can see, there's no real difference between the two graphs, or no major ones at least, meaning that the internal resonance characteristics of each of these enclosures is practically identical.
But we also want to know about frequency response, because that should also give us an indication of whether they sound different, but let's go ahead and do that. For this, I want to hook up my OmniMic V2. I absolutely love this measurement microphone, and I'm going to hook this up and test both of these responses. All right, now this is where things get a little tricky, because as we take a look at the low end, both of these look identical. But as we go up in frequency, we see this huge dip at 10 kilohertz. Now that's the 3D printed version. Why is that there? Well, it's not the enclosure. This is actually an issue with this BMR that I got. I actually ordered 4 of them, and all 4 of them are exhibiting the exact same behavior, not just in this enclosure, but multiple different enclosures, as well as in free air, meaning that it's actually an issue with the driver and not the actual enclosure. So unfortunately, I can't get a perfect one-to-one match, but if that 10 kilohertz wasn't there, I think you can easily see that these would have been identical as far as frequency response goes.
Now you're probably thinking, that's it. That means that it is completely the same. We've tested the frequency response and we've tested the ZMA. Since those are all the same, therefore the speaker should sound exactly the same. But we're not quite done just yet. Let's go ahead and do one more test, and this might be a test that you're unfamiliar with. This last test, once again, we'll use the OmniMic, and this is called a bass decay test. Basically, what we're trying to find out is whether the bass decays at the same rate in each enclosure. And if we look at this, they look fairly similar up past 100 hertz. But once we get down in the lower range, about 60 hertz and so, we're seeing that the bass is actually taking longer to decay in the 3D cabinet versus the wooden enclosure. Now, the most reasonable explanation for this is the enclosure itself is resonating. And this is really where we would expect to see a problem with the 3D printed enclosure. And we are seeing it, although not nearly as bad as I would have expected. Now, I say that because the 60 hertz range really isn't any higher than anything else, even though it is higher than the wooden enclosure. And there might be a couple reasons why this enclosure has done a little bit better. One of that is maybe the shape of it. With those curved sides, it does make that a little bit stronger. Although it might also have to do with a little bit of infill and the walls that we use. See, when you 3D print an enclosure, not every 3D printed enclosure is the same. The amount of infill that you use and the wall count is going to have a direct effect on how well a 3D printed enclosure will sound in the end and how close it will sound to a wooden enclosure. Now, in this particular test with the rule breaker, I would say that this is absolutely listenable to. Now, I listened to this with both the 3D printed version and the wooden enclosure and really didn't notice any major differences, even in that base decay region of the 60 hertz that it's showing. Now, another reason why the rule breaker is probably not going to be a big issue, especially in that 60 hertz range, is because this speaker is really designed as a center channel speaker or for home theater. And so you're going to be crossing this over between 80 and 120 hertz. That 60 hertz is actually going to be on the downward slope, meaning the amount that you're actually playing through it is going to be relatively low. So where does this leave us in the 3D printed versus wooden enclosure debate? Well, with this particular speaker, I would say that, hey, absolutely, go ahead and 3D print this speaker. You can do that, and I don't think you would have any issues. And this is really exciting news for those of you who don't have a full workshop, then can afford a 3D printer. Now, if you are looking for a 3D printer, check out the Creality K1 or their new K1C, which I'm actually going to be reviewing on the channel soon, so stay tuned. If you're a hi-fi guy that has to have absolutely the best of everything and you can't make any sacrifices at all, then a 3D printed enclosure may not be for you, especially if you're going to be doing lower bass. I do think there needs to be some more testing done, and those of you who are interested in it, please go ahead and do it. I'm going to create a thread down on the forum and make sure to put some results on there. Now, if you think I should have tested something else, or you think I should have done something differently, throw it down in the comment sections. Also, let me know if you were surprised by the results or not. All right, guys, we're trying to get to 100,000 subscribers this year, so please hit that subscribe button if you enjoyed this video. Otherwise, guys, this is Toid's DIY Audio, and I'm out.